Coming up on SBU-TV, we take a look at the new campus brewery, and we find out what famous band is playing at spring weekend. Hello and welcome to SBU-TV. I'm Ryan McDonough.
And I'm Jasmine Foster. St. Bonaventure University has started a brewing company that allows students to help with the entire process. Dakota Ward finds out how and where you can get a sip of the finest beer in the Enchanted Mountains.
St. Bonaventure University has recently launched a new program to help students become more involved with the Brown is the New Green initiative. The Bonaventure Brewing Company. With minds from the Science, Business, and Communication Department, BBC teaches students how to crop, brew, and distribute the product throughout the Olean area. After being approved by the New York State Department of Education, BBC has started to manufacture beer in the garage right next to the maintenance building on campus. Pauline Hoffman, Vice President of Communication at BBC, reflects on why this opportunity would help get students involved.
Do any students in general want to get their hands right in the crap? I mean, literally right down in the manure and being a part of the earth, just as St. Francis would have wanted us to do.
With cooperation with St. Bonaventure University, BBC has adopted one of the many open fields on campus to start growing its own hops.
The fact that as a Franciscan university, we do pay attention to the environment and we're very conscious of how we interact with the environment. Also, I mean, we're Bonas, of course. Beer drinking is key.
BBC has started production and has its product on the shelves at local beer distributors and is featured as the current beer of the month at 4 Mile Brewing. To make sure the taste is perfect, SBU-TV has decided to conduct a BBC beer test with students.
After a long, hard day's work of studying and intense academics, I always reach for Bonaventure's finest.
It's actually pretty good.
Tastes better than my cooking.
Das schmeck! Wow!
The Bonaventure Brewing Company is a seasonal beer and will only be available until the middle of May. If you want the best beer brewed from the foothills of the Enchanted Mountains, make sure to pick up a six-pack. With SBU-TV, I'm Dakota Ward.
For a free six-pack and information, please call 585-755-2890. Again, for a free six-pack and information, call 585-755-2890.
During the winter, St. Bonaventure's admissions office introduced a new Bonawolf to the community. Jackie Roberts got the story.
Who says you need thumbs to operate a smartphone? A new campaign at St. Bonaventure thinks paws are just fine. From admiring campus, burning some calories at the Richter, or even making yourself a snack at our residence halls, this new Bonnie will capture it all. Your very own Bonawolf debuted his own Snapchat account.
Snapchat is an application on your phone that allows you to interact with followers and record videos and pictures
that are viewable for up to 24 hours. The creator of the new Snapchat campaign, Sharon Myers, hopes the new wolf will be a howling success.
He gets to tell the Bonaventure story kind of as a new entity on campus, and it allows us to put a face to the Snapchat account.
But the account isn't only for current Bonaventure students.
Students kind of have fun with it. They'll see him at events. They'll see him around.
It's the cutest thing I've ever seen.
Wow, this guy's had a crazy, I thought I had a crazy day today.
Oh my goodness, it drinks coffee.
So cute. I'm so glad we have him.
Looks like the wolf pack just keeps on growing. For SBU-TV, I'm Jackie Roberts.
Jackie seems to be looking a little bit different, don't you think, Jasmine?
She looks the same to me.
And now for something completely different.
Where are they now? SBU-TV caught up with an old friend.
Last year, SBU-TV caught up with Sway Wigston, a freshman who filled the void of St. Bonaventure's quadless campus by making his own in the lounge of First Falconio. But a lot can change in 1 year.
Yeah, so, as you know, I was kicked out of the First Fail Lounge from rocking too hard and hacking some sack. So I came here, and I actually think I'm in, like, a really bad part of town.
Actually, a gruesome injury has held Sway back from continuing his guitar career.
I don't know if you saw the documentary about me in the Fail Lounge, but I was doing my first show, and it was going really well. I was playing my hit song called Opinions, and, you know, I did a stage dive, and I didn't realize, I thought it sold out. It did the opposite of that. No one was there. And, you know, I landed on my wrist. Well, that's why I'm on the uke. It's smaller. The neck is easier to, like, you know, hit the good chords.
And where does Sway go from here?
Everywhere. Like, name a place. I'll go there. Yeah, so, you know, I had to give up sacking, like, hacky sacking. I'm pretty good at juggling the soccer ball. I'll just show you my skills real quick. Yeah, so I'm pretty strong. You know, I kick the ball pretty far. So, you know, anytime you need someone to kick something pretty far, just hit me up.
We'll believe it when we see it. With SBU-TV and Sway Wigston, I'm Ryan McDonough.
But with opinions, they can hurt other people's feelings.
Allegheny police have since picked up Sway, and he is in the town's holding facility. We will be right back after this commercial message.
Hello, my name is Dennis Reardon, and I'm running for university president at St. Bonaventure. I am the best candidate for the job with some great ideas. And right now, you're going to stop what you're doing, and you're going to listen to what I have to say. First, we need to build the wall between us and Olean, and have the people of Olean pay for it. I will be the greatest party president God ever created, I can tell you that. I can also tell you that we're going to tax the hell out of the history department, because they are always stuck in the past and never with the program. My hands are pretty big, but my ex-wife might say otherwise. My fingers are long and beautiful. You need a leader with big hands to get the job done. Sorry, losers and haters, but my IQ is one of the highest, and you all know it. I am a very caring and kind person. People who know me tend to like me a lot. Vote for Dennis Reardon. Let's make St. Bonaventure great again. I approve this message.
Welcome back to SBU-TV. Studies show more women this year have earned partner positions in major companies than ever before. But Jackie Roberts found out that women aren't the only group making strides into the corporate leadership.
To find a successful business plan, sometimes it takes a little sniffing around. This is Oliver, the co-owner of Metro Roberts Real Estate. Agents say Oliver and his partner, Jim Roberts, bring the term man's best friend to life.
I basically do the bookkeeping, the financial aspect of it. And Oliver is more hands-on. He's in the office every day early, and he's working with the agents.
Some of this year's top-selling agents say Oliver has positively impacted their day-to-day operation.
Oliver is a real asset to Metro Roberts.
He's a real good mascot and motivator.
Come to our office for a day, see what it's like to have Oliver here.
And even when Oliver can't be in the office, he's still there in his own way.
Oliver says his only regret in starting the company is not ordering company apparel in dog sizes.
Jim Roberts also wishes Oliver could sport a Metro jacket. But if that's the only fallback, he thinks all companies should consider adding a canine on board.
And some of the dog skill sets are just great. You know, a lot of them are like Oliver went to UB.
But not just any dog.
I wouldn't want to bring in a Doberman or something like that. They just don't have the temperament.
To spread awareness about dogs joining corporations, Oliver did some digging into social media.
I am friends of Oliver on Facebook.
He's really getting good on Instagram and Twitter.
The one when he was reading the Define Your Home magazine, I've seen him do that before in the office, and it was nice to see that there was a picture of him on there doing it.
Oliver posts about his workday, his family, and even his business cards. They said dogs can't do real estate, and Oliver said he's not quite sold on that yet. With SBU-TV, I'm Jackie Roberts.
It's about time dogs are getting credit for their hard work. Oliver says it may take a few more movements for cats to get similar acknowledgments.
Have you been single for a while and just can't seem to find the one? Are you sick of going on dates with people you have nothing in common with? Do the Bonnies hold a special place in your heart? If so, you'll want to check out this epic love story.
If you're feeling lonely, go to BonniesOnly.com.
Been single for a really long time and had trouble talking to girls, so I'm better online.
7 hours so far. Yeah, I don't know how we can.
I think we've already made it.
Yeah. Made it past the six hour mark.
Yeah.
We're golden.
That's the toughest part of it.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've been thinking really hard about this for the last 2 hours, and I think I'm finally going to propose to Madeline. Yeah. Thank you.
Change you deserve and visit www.bonniesonly.com. We'll be right back after this commercial message.
What if I told you Cinderella never actually made it to the ball? That being on fire holds a different meaning. What if I told you that big victories off the court don't count in the win column? That you can't shoot your way out of turmoil? What if I told you that a league that accepts everyone probably shouldn't? Winless, directed by Ryan McDonough, and part of an SBU-TV film series.
Welcome back to SBU-TV. A member of the Bonaventure community needs your support. Let's take a look.
Definitely miss Paul here in the U.S. and definitely in the Coop Lab, but if he wants to go to Canada, I think we should all get together and make sure we can send him there.
If you find it in your heart to donate, please donate, because Paul is an awesome person. He deserves a great retirement.
I thought Paul already moved to Canada.
If you would like to help, donate via GoFundMe or show your support by using the hashtag PledgesForPaul.
A group of rising stars is headed to Olean later this month. Vinny Bellardini has the inside scoop.
After months of intense negotiation, St. Bonaventure's Campus Activities Board has closed the deal on a world-renowned musical act to headline this year's spring weekend.
I'm Skip Chesterfield from Farmington, USA, and these are my boys.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. St. Bonaventure's Riley Center will soon be the site for America's favorite alternative metal bluegrass ensemble, Skip and the Boys. Not only will April's concert be an exciting treat for Bona students, it will also be a milestone for Skip and the Boys. It will be the very first live concert of their promising young careers.
Skip, you're out of tune!
You know, Skip is a real good guy and a great musician, but he can get a little bossy sometimes.
Skip, I take your attitude like a feeling in my leg!
We've been scoping these guys out for months. They're the real deal. I'm really proud of our exec board for pulling off the impossible and getting such a big group to come to a small campus.
You know, I'm not really sure how we got started. Skip just told us to come over one day, and next thing we knew, we were the greatest thing in Farmington.
Skip and the Boys will undoubtedly bring masses of fans to the area, as well as an unpredictable amount of economic growth through their ticket and merchandise sales.
This will be the biggest thing this area has seen in a long time. Someday, it'll be looked back upon as the launching off point for the biggest alternative metal bluegrass band of all time.
For SBU-TV, I'm Vinny Ballardini.
All Bonna students will receive free admission to Skip and the Boys by presenting their student IDs. General seating for others will start at, quote, whatever you got in your pocket. That does it for us here at SBU-TV. I'm Jasmine Foster.
And I'm Ryan McDonough. And don't forget what day it is.